choosing of best inputs in order to produce the best output. That is called optimization. Okay, so otherwise we can say action of making the best or most effective use of situation resources. For example, we consider a DC motor. Okay, in DC motor you are going to control the speed of the DC motor in closed loop. So in open loop you cannot control the speed. So because when you are going to control the DC motor in open loop, so when you are going to apply load, the speed of the motor going to be reduced. But you need to maintain the DC motor in particular speed. Okay, so for that we need to go for closed loop control. Okay, so in order to maintain speed at some certain level, we go for closed loop control. In closed loop control, we are going to use controller. Okay, so normally or most of the time you get to use only PID controller, PA controller. So PA controller, so in PA controller there are two tuning parameters there. So one is proportional gain, another one is integral gain. Okay, so that should be choose to. So based upon that value, the response of the DC motor going to be vary. Okay, so for that we go for optimization technique. So by using that optimization technique, we are going to choose the best value for that proportional gain and integral gain, so that going to be control the system. Okay, so that is called optimization. Just you are going to choose the best inputs in order to achieve your desired results. Okay, for that only we go for optimization. So the optimization normally used in different areas. So that areas nothing but allocation of resources. For example, you consider some manufacturing industry. Okay, in manufacturing industry you are going to maximize the profit. Okay, so in order to maximize the profit, you have to allocate the resource and you have to control the process of that manufacturing. Okay, so for that we can use optimization, and then we can use optimization technique in a design of systems. For example, you are going to design any system. Okay, so we can apply optimization or to improve the characteristics of that design or characteristics of that system. Okay, so for that also we can use that optimization techniques. So, and also the optimization technique can be used in the control system in order to find out the control variables. So already I told, right, controlling of DC motor speed in closed loop. Okay, so should we follow the reference input? In order to track that reference input, you have to adjust the control variable. For example, you consider PA controller, you must adjust the KP and KA of the PA controller in order to track that reference value. Okay, so during that kind of system, we can apply this optimization techniques. So normally optimization techniques can be used for maximize the problem, so maximize the system, or it can be used for a minimization. So it can be used for maximization the problem or minimization the problem. For example, you consider in financial sector you have to maximize the profit, so we can use optimization technique. For example, you consider production industry. Okay, so you want to minimize the cost of the product. Okay, so during the time we can use that optimization to minimize that problem. Okay, so optimization can be used in the two things. One is maximize the problem or minimize the problem. Okay, next we consider simple example. So this is inverted parabola, right? Inverted parabola. So in inverted parabola, you are going to find the maximum value. So in order to find out maximum value, we can do different things. Okay, we can apply trial and error method. That means you got to apply different x value. Okay, for different x value, then you can find out the value of y. Okay, so you got to apply different x and then you can find out the value for y. So from that values you can find out the maximum value. Otherwise we can apply a derivative function. Okay, just you got to apply derivative that should be equal to zero. Just you got to apply x value and then find out the derivative value. So when it is equal to zero, then that condition known as maximum condition for that given problem. Okay, so system is very simple. Okay, this system is very simple, so we can use a derivative function in order to find out the maximum value. For example, you consider the system, it is very more complex, right? It has more it has local minima and global minima points, combination of that things. Okay, so in complex system we cannot use the numerical optimization or derivative function or to find out the maximum value. Okay, so in order to find out that maximum or minimum point for different x value, so we go for optimization technique. So by using that optimization technique, we can easily find out the value for x. So depending upon the condition, maximization condition or minimization condition. So next, in optimization technique, you have to consider two parameter. So one is objective function. So what is objective function? The value you are trying to optimize. So consider any system. In system, which parameter, which things you are going to optimize? Okay. So for that, you consider this square, right? So you are going to optimize this square. The square has two values, two sides, right? A and B. So in order to optimize that square, so you have to find out the area. Okay. So this area consider as objective function for this square. So this area can be maximized, or in the area can be minimized, or this area can be maintain it to some set value. Okay, so in this problem the area is considered as a objective function. So this objective function can be maximized or minimized or set at some desired value based upon your requirement. Okay, so that is nothing but the objective function for the given problem. Okay, so value you are trying to optimize in the given system. So for in this example, you are going to optimize the area of the square. So area is considered as a objective function for the given problem. Okay, so for the problem may be a star b or a plus b or something else. Okay, we can use any kind of arithmetical units, arithmetical variables, okay, arithmetical equation in order to maximize or minimize the problem. So next one is you have to, so the function may be, so you are going to minimize the cost of the system or maximize the speed of the system or minimize the weight of the system or maximize the profit or minimize the waste. Okay, so we can choose any kind of objective function depending upon your application. Okay, so we can say this is the example for a objective function: minimize the cost, maximize the speed, minimize the weight, or maximize the profit and minimize the waste. Okay, so this is example, simple example for that objective function. So you can choose appropriately objective function. For example, you are going to control the DC motor. Okay, so in order to control the DC motor, you are going to take the speed of the DC motor and compare it with the reference, and it going to process via PA controller. Okay, so in DC motor control, so you got to minimize the error, speed error. Okay, so then the function is minimization function. So you are going to minimize the speed error. Okay, so you are going to choose the objective function exactly for your system. So then only you can easily find out the optimized value for the given problem. Next in optimization technique is a decision variable. Okay, decision variable, the value that optimizer can change. So already we see the example, square example, okay? In the square example, the area is considered as a objective function, okay? So this area depends upon two variables. One is A, another one is B, okay? So this value can be optimized by using optimization algorithm. So this variable known as the decision variable. This variable known as decision variable for the given problem. So here you are going to construct the square. So in order to construct the square, you are going to adjust the variable A and B. So this variable is comes from optimizer or optimization algorithm. So this variable also known as manipulated variable or design variable. So this is going to be vary depending upon your application. So it can be decision variable, it can be manipulated variable, or it can be decision variable. So in order to execute any optimization algorithm, first you have to fix the objective function. So objective function should be mentioned clearly or derived clearly, and then you have to fix the decision variable. So what kind of decision variable you are going to adjust by using optimization, okay? So these two things should be considered during execution of optimization algorithm, okay? So one is objective function, another one is decision variable. So this is a basic of optimization, okay? Optimization, nothing but the, you are going to choose the best input to produce the best output from the system, okay? So optimization can be used in the maximization problem or minimization problem. And then in optimization, you have to consider two things. One is objective function. So this is nothing but where you are trying to optimize. So second one is a decision variable. The variable is comes from optimization algorithm. So next, we're going to see about research opportunities in electrical engineering. So there are different areas: optimization of controllers, optimal allocation of power and power systems, optimal design of electrical machine, and parameter estimation or identification of any system using optimization algorithm. And optimization of controller, for example, you can consider in power system, right? In power system, you studied about a multi-area system or automatic generation control, okay? In automatic generation control, you are going to control or you are going to minimize the change in frequency of the system, or you are going to control the tidal and power flow, right? So for that, we got to use controller. So that controller parameter can be optimized in automatic generation control. As well as in multi-area system, we have to maintain terminal voltage at a constant level. So for that, we got to use AVR, automatic voltage regulator. So in automatic voltage regulator also, you have to use controller, right? The controller parameter need to be optimized by using optimization algorithm. So in case of power converter, right? For example, you are going to design some power converter. That power converter will deliver the power to the some load, right? The load need some constant output, constant voltage or constant current. So for that, we go for a closed loop control. So during the time, you need to control that, you need to optimize that parameter of the controller. So in case of electrical machine, so you need to control the speed of the machine or torque of the machine, okay? So for that also, you go for closed loop control, and you are going to use controller. So that controller, and then here, there also you can control the or optimize the parameter of the controller, okay? So this is a first area in the optimization of controller. So next one is optimal allocation of power in power system, okay? In power system, you have two area. One is economic power dispatch and unit commitment, right? So economic power dispatch, you are going to dispatch the power with the minimum fuel cost. So this is objective. So minimization function, we are going to minimize the fuel cost of the power generation, okay, with the allocation of power for different power generating units. So for that also we can apply optimization algorithm for allocation of power for different unit by reducing that fuel cost. So in that area you can use optimization algorithm, and also you can use optimization algorithm in the unit commitment plot. So nowadays that optimization algorithm used to for solve that combined economic emission dispatch. That means combined economic emission nothing but you are going to reduce the fuel cost as well as emission cost. That means you are going to reduce the CO2 level in that power generation unit, thermal unit, okay. So that is nothing but combined economic emission dispatch. And also in combined economic emission dispatch, they are using including that renewable energy sources. So how to minimize the cost of the that power generation with including the renewable energy generation like solar energy, wind energy. When you are going to include that solar, wind in the power system unit, so how we can minimize the cost? So this is the current research area in the power system. And then optimal design of electrical machines. For example, nowadays robotics is a booming area, right? And robotics, we have to use electrical machines, normally servo motor, stepper motor we are using, okay. So in order to use that electrical machine, that means servo motor, stepper motor in the robot, okay, that machine weight should be minimum, right? So in order to reduce the weight, we can use optimization algorithm to reduce the weight. And same way, that should be designed for higher torque, okay. And also the optimization thinking can be used for increase the efficiency of the electrical machines. So in order to increase the efficiency, we can use optimization algorithm, okay. So optimal design of electrical machines. So next one is a parameter estimation or ID deviation, okay. For example, you have some system. So for the system, you have to find out the parameter. So what are the parameter of that given system? So for that also we can use optimization algorithm to find out the parameter of the given system. For example, you consider DC motor, and DC motor you need to find out the different variables or different parameter. For example, KV, torque constant, voltage constant, speed constant, and moment of inertia, friction, okay. So that parameter can be identified by using this optimization algorithm also. So these are the most research area in the electrical engineering, okay. So next we are going to see about case study, okay. Tuning of PA controller using PSO for speed control of the MDC motor. So I'm going to present some optimization using PSO for speed control of the MDC motor. Okay, so consider this is the block diagram used to for a block diagram of the speed control of BMDC motor, okay, which consists of a buck boost converter, BMDC motor, and then comparator, and then speed controller, and periodic bulb generator. So in this block we are going to measure, that means the PMDC motor speed going to be measured by the speed sensor and going to be compared with the reference set speed command, okay. So and then it produce some error. So this error is processed via PA controller or speed controller, speed PA controller, okay. So the PA controller provides some duty cycle. So this duty cycle is processed via periodic impulse generator. So in periodic impulse generator, just you go to compare a triangular wave with the duty cycle. So consider this duty cycle. So it can be produce some pulse, okay. So this pulse nothing but the periodic impulse. So this one is going to be control the buck boost converter, okay. So it's going to be control the output voltage of the TMDC motor. So this is closed loop control of PMDC speed control system, okay. Just you have to measure the speed and compare with reference, and then the DRS process speed controller, it's going to provide duty cycle. That duty cycle is compared with the triangular wave. The triangular wave provides some pulses for the converter. The converter going to be convert or adjust the output voltage of the PMDC motor. That's why you can control the speed of the DC motor, okay. So in order to apply optimization algorithm, we go for a transfer function model, okay. So first you have to find out the transfer function model of the buck boost converter, and then we must find out the transfer function model of PMDC motor, and then you have to find out the transfer function model for PA control, okay. So this buck boost converter and PMDC motor are in cascade manner, right? Both are in cascade, but PA controller is placed in the feedback loop, okay. So both are in cascade, but PA controller is present in the feedback loop, okay. So first you have to find out the transfer function for that buck boost converter, and then you have to find out the transfer function for PMDC motor, and then you go to cascading that two transfer function model. Next you have to find out the transfer function for the PA controller, so that should be included in the feedback loop, okay. So for that, first you have to fix the specification for the buck boost converter, okay. So these are the specification used for this case studies, okay. VD is equal to 198 supply voltage, and then resistance, capacitance, inductance are, and then output voltage, and then duty cycle. So next is this is the specification used for this case studies for DC motor. Moment of inertia, friction, back EMF constant, torque constant, and then resistance, inductance of the armature, okay. So next, by using these details, you have to find out the transfer function. So the G1 used to for transfer function for buck boost converter. Okay, the G1 is the transfer function for a buck boost converter, and G2 is the transfer function for a DC motor. So this is already available in the internet, okay. You can refer that transfer function model. Just you go to apply these values. You can apply this specification in the already available transfer function. So you can easily use the transfer function model. So G1 for a transfer function model for that buck boost converter, G2 is the transfer function model for the DC motor. So plant both are in a cascade, just you have to multiply both, right? So plant equal to G1 star G2, okay. So system in open loop, right? There is no closed loop control. So for the system, I'm going to find out the step response, okay. So for that, I'm going to obtain the step response from that plant by using this command, step of plant, okay. So this is a response I'm obtained from that plant, okay. So this is the final transfer function for that given plant in MATLAB, okay. So these things is implemented in the MATLAB, okay. So this step response. So in open loop, you cannot control the speed, right? So not to control that speed, we go for closed loop. So for that, we got to include some controller in between. We are going to include a controller in feedback. So normally we are going to use PA controller. Already I explained in the system, right? We are going to use PA controller. So PA controller parameter can be tuned with the different methods. Okay, so first one is trial and error method. Okay, so you can use a trial and error method. So where I'm manually, you can apply value for KP and KE. So manually you can apply KP KE value, and then you just see that response. So whether the response is okay for you, then you can fix that KP KE value. But when you are going to use a trial and error method, it take more time to find out the value for KP and KE. So next method is ZN method. So in ZN method, just you go to take the open loop response, and then you go to draw the tangent line, okay, and then you have to find out the parameter A and L. Okay, so by using this value A and L, so we can easily find out the initial value for the KPK, okay, by using this formula. So this is the initial value, so not the fine-tuned value. Okay, so initial guess for that PA controller or PED controller or P controller. Okay, so the ZN method can be used from the open loop response. Okay, same way I'm going to apply the tangent line, and then I'm going to find out the value for A and B. Okay, by using this formula. So I'm getting value is KP is 0.0358 by using ZN method, and KA is 3.0643. So this value is obtained from the ZN method. That means it is derived from that open loop response. So next you have to construct the PA controller. Okay, so just you have to use this equation, controller equal to KP plus KA divided by S. So this is nothing but the proportional gain. So this is nothing but the integral part. Okay, next, after designing the controller, just you have to use feedback control concept. So for that you have to use feedback command. Okay, just you have to combine that plant and the controller in feedback manner. So by using this command, okay, see that CL plant equal to feedback controller star plant comma one, nothing but the set feed or reference command. Okay, so plant should be follow that command input. So after creating that closed loop plant, I'm going to find out the step response for that closed loop plant. Okay, by using this command, step closed loop plant. Okay, so this is a response I am getting from that closed loop plant. So this is a response of that closed loop control system of the speed control of DMDC. But you can see that it has more overshoot and undershoot, right? The overshoot will be is around 1.7, right? 1.7. The undershoot is around 0.45. okay, and also the system response is more oscillatory. Okay, so by using a ZN method, you can find out the initial value for that KP and KE. Okay, so we cannot use that KP KE is optimal value for that given problem. Okay, so in order to achieve that best value for KP KE, so we go for optimization algorithm. So here we are going to use particle swarm optimization in order to optimize the value for KP and KE. Okay, so this is a block diagram or a flowchart for a particle swarm optimization. So particle swarm optimization is mimic the behavior of the bats. Okay, bat swarming behavior. Okay, so in particle swarm optimization, we have to use some initialization. So you have to initialize the swarm population, velocity, maximum number of iterations, and then acceleration constant and inertia weight. So acceleration constant nothing but the c1 and c2. So this nothing but the acceleration constant. So inertia constant nothing but the omega. And then velocity is denoted by V, and then swarm population is denoted by x. Okay, so in order to execute PSO, first you got to initialize the population, velocity, maximum number of iteration, oscillation constant, initial constant, and also you have to fix the stopping criteria. Okay, stopping criteria nothing but you have to fix some minimum or maximum objective function value. Okay, but for our system you are going to minimize the error, right? Just you got to minimize the speed error. Okay, so just you got to fix the minimum objective function value, nothing but the stopping criteria. Okay, so after initialization of population, velocity, initial velocity, maximum number of iteration, so for initial population you are going to find out the fitness function, otherwise we can say objective function value. Okay, for initial set of population, for example, you consider, I'm going to consider a 10 set of population, 10 set of KPKA. Okay, so that for each set of KPKA I'm going to measure that fitness value, otherwise called I'm going to measure the objective function. Okay, so just I'm going to send the first set and then I'm going to measure the fitness function. So both value going to be stored in the system. Okay, so for all set of KPKA I'm going to measure the fitness. So here fitness nothing but speed error. Okay, so for each set of KPKA I'm going to measure the speed error and stored in the computer. So after finding a fitness value, so I'm going to short that fitness from minimum to maximum. Okay, so our aim is to minimize the speed error, right? So for that I'm going to short that fitness function or fitness value from minimum to maximum. Okay, minimum value to f of minimum to, or f1 to f10. Okay, so I'm going to short that fitness function from minimum to maximum. So this minimum value is considered as global best or population best in initial state. Okay, so you can see that the equation here, pb and then gb, right? So population best and global best. So initially the top minimum value is considered as population best and global best. Okay, so next, after finding fitness value and shorting the fitness value and then finding population best and global best, next you are going to check the condition whether the maximum iteration reached or stopping criteria reached. That means just you got to check the maximum iteration. So now in we are in initial condition, so maximum iteration never reached. Okay, so next you have to check the stopping criteria. That means you are going to check the this minimum fitness with the criteria minimum objective function value. If that this minimum value is reached that or less than that of stopping criteria, then you can stop that PSO algorithm and go to print the result. So otherwise, if the stopping criteria not reached, we go for a looping, that is called iteration. So in iteration we are going to update the velocity. Okay, so update the velocity by using this function. So velocity can be updated by using this function. So after updating the velocity, I'm going to update the population. Okay, xi plus 1 equal to xi plus vi plus 1. So vi plus 1 updated velocity. So xi plus 1 nothing but updated swarm population. Okay, just by using these two equation, just I'm going to update the velocity as well as population. Okay, so after updating that velocity in the population, for updated population I'm going to find out the fitness function. So for each updated population set, I'm going to find out the fitness function. Okay, so for all set of updated population, I'm going to find out the fitness function. Once again, I'm going to short that fitness function from minimum to maximum.
After starting that fitness function, I'm going to find out the population based and the global based. Okay. Now the population based is the minimum value from that started fitness. And global based nothing but just you have to compare the minimum value of this fitness value with the already global best value. Okay. Just you have to compare with already global best value, whether the current minimum is less than that already global value, then you can replace that global best value to current minimum fitness function value. Otherwise, we can use already existing global fitness function. Okay. So this will be continued up to the maximum iteration or stopping criteria reached. Okay. So once the maximum iteration or stopping criteria reached, the POSO will provide the value for best, provide the value for KP and KA. Okay. So this is a flowchart for tuning up PA controller using PSO. In MATLAB, you have to initialize that PSO. So this is the command used to for initialize the PSO in MATLAB. So first you have to declare the function. Function nothing but the objective function, right? You need to create the objective function for that particle swarm optimization. So for that, I'm going to use function equal to at some function value. Okay. And then you have to initialize the number of variables. Okay. Here I'm going to adjust the two parameter. One is proportional gain and the index gain. So number of variable. Otherwise, we can say a decision variable or manipulated variable or a design variable. Okay. So this is two, or decision variable or manipulated variable or design variable is considered as two, because we are going to optimize two parameters. One is KP, another one is KA. Okay. Next, you have to provide limits for that two parameter KP and KA. So this value can be obtained from that ZN method. Okay. So in ZN method, you see that KP is 0.0358 and KA is 3.064. Okay. So I am going to use KP is 0.0121. Okay. So this is for a range of KP only in between 0.0121. So this is a range of KA only in between 0.3 to 30. Okay. So this value can be fixed from the ZN method. Okay. So next you have to provide some option for that PSO. So we are going to use PSO, particle swarm optimization. So particle swarm optimization. Next you have to fix the swarm population. So I'm going to use swarm size is 10 and maximum iteration is, I'm going to fix as 10. And then this is used for displaying the result. Okay. The displaying result in iteration manner, and then plot function. So plot function used to for plotting that best fitness function for every iteration. Okay. So next I'm going to execute that particle swarm optimization by using this command. So in this command, you have to provide function, objective function, number of variables, and then lower bound, upper bound for that variables, and then any options provided in the MATLAB function. Okay. So it going to be execute that function, and then finally it store the result in the X. Okay. So we can find out the best value for KP, K in the variable X. Okay. By using KP is X of 1, K is equal to X of 2. So this is a function declaration for the PSO and the MATLAB. So first you go to declare the objective function, and then you go to fix the number of variables, and then you go to fix the lower bound, upper bound for the KP and KA. Next you go to fix the option for the PSO. Next you go to function declaration for the PSO, and then you go to execute that the program. Okay. So next you go to see about objective function, how to provide objective function. So in order to execute that function, then you can use function call. So you have to use this syntax in the MATLAB function. So here we are going to use a specification for boost converter and DC motor. And then you go to form the transfer function for buck boost converter and then DC motor. And then you go to create the plant G1 star G2. And then you go to provide a value for KPK. Okay, this KPK comes from a PSO. Okay, so you see that function. The function F equal to some name bracket, in bracket you have to use PAD, right? So this values comes from PSO. Okay, this contain two value. So KP equal to PAD of 1 and K equal to PAD of 2. So this two values comes from PSO. So by using this value, you have to construct the controller, and then you have to form the feedback control loop by using this instruction. Okay, so after constructing this feedback loop, I'm going to take step response and then I'm going to find the error. Okay, so F equal to mean of absolute value of 1 minus x. Okay, so 1 is the set speed command or a reference command. So x is nothing but a response from the plant. So just I'm going to take a difference between the command reference and actual response from that plant, and then I'm going to take absolute value. Okay, so why I am taking absolute value? Because just you go to take 1 minus xs, then it contain both positive and negative error. Sometimes that both the positive and negative error will be penalized to zero. Okay, so you cannot find out the exact value for KPK. So for that only I'm going to use absolute value, and then I'm going to take mean value. Okay, so mean of the total error. Okay, so this is a creation of the function not optimize the KPKA for a speed control of PMDC. So next time we'll execute that PSO. Okay, so every iteration it going to be find out the 10 fitness. Okay, because we are using 10 population, right? 10 population and 10 iteration. So totally, so initially it take 10 10 execution. Initially it execute 10 times. So for every iteration it's going to be execute for 10 times. So totally function evaluation is totally 110. Okay, so for each iteration is going to be evaluate for 10 times. Okay, 10 20 30 40 50 60. Okay, so this is the evaluation of fitness function for each iteration. So this is the and the minimum fitness function from the each iteration. Okay, minimum fitness function or best function value, objective function value from the each iteration. So this is the mean of the fitness function for each iteration. So this is a converging graph in between iteration and the fitness function. Okay, so from by using PSO, so I am getting KP value is 0.0103 and K is 0.3. So this this is the transfer function model for the given feedback plant. Okay, so after that I'm going to compare the result of ZN method and PSO method, right? So this is already, you know, this is a result of ZN method. So you see that the blue color line. So this is a result of PSO. Okay, and just you compare this both, right? The PSO has better result than ZN method, right? Because it has less overshoot and less undershoot and settle quickly. But ZN method has more oscillation. So next I'm going to show some MATLAB simulation. So this is the implementation of the PSO code, right, in the MATLAB. And then, so this is the implementation of that objective function in MATLAB. So I'm going to execute that PSO, right, in order to find out the value for KP and KA. Just I'm going to execute. See that? So for every iteration it will provide some results, right? So iteration 0, that means initial iteration, on iteration 1. The fourth iteration is completed. Fifth iteration. Sixth iteration. Seventh. And eighth. Ninth iteration. And after 10th iteration is completed, okay, it will provide the result for KPK. So say result x is equal to 0.0188 and then KP is 0.0188, K is equal to 0.3. okay, so this is the best value for KPK. So next you have to test that result, okay? So for that I'm going to execute this. So this is already find out from that ZN method, okay? So this is comes from PSO. So I'm going to execute this. Once again, I will show that some plot, right? So this output plot from that PSO, that mean convergent plot, right? Okay. So next I'm going to execute. I'm going to compare ZN method with the PSO optimization. So for that I'm going to execute these commands. Okay. So this is a comparison of ZN method and PSO, okay. So in ZN method, system is have oscillatory response, but in case of PSO optimization, the response is very better than the ZN method, okay. But normally in the PSO, you should execute that PSO for 100 trials, okay. Just you have to execute 100 times, and then from 100 trials you have to find out the best result. Okay, so don't use a single trial, just you got to use 100 trial, and then from 100 trial just you got to pick the best value. Okay, so that's all my presentation. Thank you. Hello.
Yeah, any queries, participants? If you have any queries, kindly send in the chat box. Dr. Prem Kumar,
Yes.
lot of algorithms are there. How
Okay.
to choose an effective algorithm from the vast variety of algorithms?
Effective algorithm, for example, recently so many algorithms developing, right? Just you have to compare with the classical algorithm, right? Just for example, just you have to develop new algorithm, and then you should be compared with the classical, like a genetic algorithm PSO. If you are giving some better result, then you can use that new algorithm.
In implementation side, how successful it so far?
Sorry?
In implementation side,
Okay.
how much successful accuracy for the optimization algorithms?
I can say you can use genetic and PSO, right? Both are already success.
Implemented algorithms,
Yeah,
okay,
no.
successful one,
So
okay.
we can use GNPSO, then a newly developed algorithm.
Okay. Any queries from participant side?
Sir, one question from
Yes.
Aishwarya Narayan. Narayan, for
Okay.
beginners in PSO,
Okay.
power system cost minimize and optimal location problem, how to code in MATLAB, suggest site or book or paper?
You can go to File Exchange, MATLAB File Exchange. Hello.
Okay, sir.
You can go to MATLAB File Exchange, and then you can search for some code, right? Relevant to the PSO or your problem, right? It has some lot of coding, right, in MATLAB File Exchange. So you can use that code for your application.
Okay, sir. Next question. Where we can get the latest optimization algorithm techniques? Information like ANT loin is latest or any new one?
Which algorithm?
Like
And loin.
ANT ant loin, ant
And loin.
loin.
Okay. So that is available in the developer, right? For example, I will share some website, right? Can you wait for that?
Okay, sir.
Next.
Best optimization technique for SRM motor, sir, for machine design optimization.
One second. I will answer for the first question, right? And then go for next question. Can you see my presentation window?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
You
please.
can see that AntLion optimizer, right? You can download from this website.
MathWorks File Exchange.
Yeah.
So, participants, you can check in a MathWorks File Exchange. Lot of algorithms are available. So, Dr. Prem Kumar sir informed the model AntLion optimizer available already available in a MathWorks.
MathWorks. You can download it and you can apply for your problems. So tell me the next question.
How to decide the initial value of KP and K before going to PSO?
Further, you go to apply ZN method, right? Just you go to apply ZN method in open loop. So it will provide some initial value for KP and KA.
I think okay, sir, presented in the slide itself.
Next question. Best optimization technique for SR motor for machine design optimization.
There is no best optimization technique in the world, right? You can use any optimization technique for any kind of problems.
Exactly, exactly.
There is no best, there is no universal optimization algorithm. So every algorithm is the best for concept, right? So you can use any kind of algorithm.
It depends on your objective function and constraints.
Yeah.
Recent and a new algorithm is there for power system problems.
Yeah, you can search in the elsewhere website, right? Lot of optimization algorithms developed day by day, right? You can search in the elsewhere, Science Direct.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you.
Hello, hello, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. My one question is there, sir. If we want to sir, tune this PI in real time, in real time, if we want to tune our PI.
Okay.
Like you are doing offline first, if the system is already changing and we want to tune, we want to design a PI such that it can update its values to tune for best performance.
Then you need to implement the PSO in real time.
PSO in real time.
Yeah.
Will it not create a lag?
Sorry.
Sir, it will take some time to optimize. So in that time,
it depends upon your system parameter, right? Normally, it will take in real time. It will take more than less than 1 second only, right? Not to execute the PSO.
So there are many systems which can arbitrarily behave, which can go anywhere in one.
No. For example, you consider you are going to apply that PA controller, right? Huh. For a speed controller of a DC motor, right?
Okay.
The response very, very, very quick, right? Then you can use PSO in real time.
Like it's a current monitoring. If we want to do current transients are very quick. So for that thing, speed transients are slow, but current transients are very quick. So for that, how we can real-time design a PI?
Then you can use the ZN method, right? Just you have to find out the mathematical model of your system, okay? First, you got to find the mathematical model, exact mathematical model, and then you got to optimize that mathematical model in offline. Then you can use that parameter in the real time, no problem.
In real time, I want to vary, sir. So the PI should need to vary in real time.
Yeah. PA need to vary in real time, then you can you go for fuzzy logic control, fuzzy tuned PAD. Okay, you can use fuzzy that concept. PAD. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, okay. Thank you.
I think it's enough. It's a time to wind up. So it's my time to deliver my vote of thanks to all. It's my immense pleasure to take this opportunity to deliver the vote of thanks in such a humble person, Dr. K. Prem Kumar, Associate Professor, Rajalakshmi Engineering College, Chennai. Thanks for accepting our invitation and deliver a session in the title of Research Opportunities and Optimization Technique. Your presentation shows brief idea about optimization algorithm in detail. As an academician and active researcher, your session with a case study in MATLAB was very useful to us. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
I'm very humbled and honored to be the one making the closing remarks of the program. And thank our chairman, Dr. Babu Manoharan, sir, and our managing director, J.C. Priya, ma'am, and our director, Shashi Shekhar, and our principal, Vadi Seshagiri Rao, and our dean, ma'am, Parvathavadini, and our convener and HOD, Jarama Pradeep and Dr. V. Namada, and our co-coordinators, Dr. P. Velmurugan and Sridharan, sir, for his wonderful support. Also, I thank Mr. Swatish and his team for his wonderful cooperation in the entire FDP program. At last, the beautiful thing about learning is that no one can take it away from you. in the pandemic period, our teaching community also faces a lot of struggles. So virus spreading, admission issues, financial constraints like salary. Still, we are continuously sharpening our knowledge through online webinars, workshops, and FDPs for improving our knowledge. We deemed it our proud privilege to stand before you to place on record the contribution of every noble heart towards the success of today's event. So I thank our participants for the patience and interest. Thanks a lot. Once again, thank you, our resource person, Dr. Prem Kumar. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Fine. Participants, we request the PPT and other materials to the resource persons. If they are sharing the materials, surely I forwarded to our mail ID also in a WhatsApp link. So kindly wait. We request all the PPTs to the resource persons. Those who are all sent the PPTs, surely we shared with you. No issue. And the certificate will be generated soon and delivered to our email ID. Don't repeatedly asking. Surely we will send as soon as possible. Thank you.
Feedback link have been posted in the chat box near faculties. Enough time will be provided. Don't worry. Many of them have not filled and we got so many requests. We are giving enough time. Kindly make sure you fill it now. Hereafter, no excuses could be permitted. Since this is the last session, kindly fill the feedback link as soon as possible.
But one humble request, don't circulate the form outside the participants link. Yeah, thank you.
Kindly do not share the link, please. Those who are currently attending the session, kindly get benefited from this. Do not feel pity for your colleagues or anyone. Kindly, those who attended the session, use this opportunity and fill the feedback. Do not share the feedback, please. No issues, Mr. Veera Raghava Reddy, sir. Kindly fill this feedback. We will consider it. Don't worry about day 1, 2, 3 or 4 days feedback. Kindly fill today's feedback. Okay, no issues, sir. Anyone who have missed the feedbacks, don't worry. No issues. We will consider. Kindly fill today's feedback without fail. Do not share the link, please. Hello. Yes, Mr. Sanjay Gupta, sir.
सर फीडबैक फिर से देना है, यहाँ थोड़ा जम्मू में ना प्रॉब्लम आ रही है, कभी बंद हो रहा कभी आ हो रहा है, नेट की प्रॉब्लम है, थोड़ा फीडबैक आज का फिर से देना।
हेलो सर, वी कुडंट अंडरस्टैंड हिंदी, कैन प्लीज टेल योर प्रॉब्लम
अगेन, देयर इज सम नेट प्रॉब्लम हियर।
ओके ओके सर, ओके ओके, इट्स बीइंग शेयर्ड अगेन, काइंडली मेक यू सर।
ओके, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू।
यस सर, वी आर पोस्टेड अगेन। Thank you, faculties, for your compliments. Recorded sessions, PPTs, everything will be mailed to your respective mail IDs. Kindly make sure that you have provided proper email ID. Check whether you have put gmail.com. Sometimes due to typing error, it may cause a gmail.com or Gmail, you may miss the dot. Kindly be cautious while filling the mail ID alone. Thank you all faculties for your compliments. If speakers permit, the presentations, we have requested the presentations. If speaker permits, we will surely mail it to you. And certificates, after some verification process, the certificates will be mailed shortly. Kindly wait for 1 or 2 days.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Hey, sir.
Sir, this is Krishnanag from Vishakhapatnam. I just wanted to thank the organizers for such a wonderful FDP. The 5 days have been very professionally organized. I wanted to appreciate that. All the sessions and the way they were very informative. And the way you were organizing everything one by one was very impressive, sir. We learned a lot, and for our college also, we want to organize with your inspiration. Thank you a lot.
Sure. Thank you so much. All credits goes to Vasan sir, Sridharan sir, and Velmurugan sir. They've really struggled a lot to get these resource persons. And really thank you all for your compliments. All credit goes to the faculty.
PP, thanks a lot, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Krishna, thank you. Sir. Thanks for your contribution. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, Mr. Arvind Pandey, sir.
Sir, I am from Maharashtra. I am also thankful for your wonderful FDP program. It was very nice for me. And it is, we know the we get more information related to how to do PhD, how to do research, and which tool is used for that. Thank you, sir. Thank you all the management, principal, sir, and all the coordinators. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Thank you for your information. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you all. Thank you to all the faculties who have complimented in the chat box. I couldn't mention each and every name since many of them have complimented so much of good responses in the chat box. We really thank you all the participants for showing interest and participating in the session.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Arun Balaji from Muscat.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you very much for the opportunity given to the management and triple for SJCE. And lot of information. Conducting a 5-day FDP is not just 5 days. It is a collective work of many days of efforts together. So thank you very much for the organizers and such a nice opportunity to learn more topics, because when I started taking notes for the topics they have discussing, the pages are not enough. Actually, for every session it's going beyond 10 pages to 12 pages. So lot of information we learned, and thanks for giving us the lot of hopes towards the research, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. As I already told, all credits goes to our faculty, Mr. Vasan Prabhu sir, Sridharan sir, and Velmurugan sir.
Velmurugan sir, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, your words, Arun Balaji sir. Thank you for your kind words.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Sir, he is from Muscat, huh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, sir. From College of Technology in Muscat.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Hello,
sir.
Yeah, this is Ashwar Narayan from UP, Uttar Pradesh, north side. So it was a very informative session in the 5 days. I have one suggestion for in a future FDP. Kindly organize one hands-on session on MATLAB. Like, we can perform end-to-end parallelly with the speaker, so it will be more beneficial to learn in a new way.
Sure, sir.
We will arrange.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay.
Sharada Devi madam, your response has been recorded, so don't worry. Don't have to submit. Your response has been recorded. Sharada Devi madam, you have posted a query that you have submitted, but suddenly your internet got disconnected. No issues. We have received your response. It has been recorded. Yes, Mr. Selvakumar sir. We have requested all the resource persons regarding the presentations. If they permit, we will surely share it to your mail IDs along with the certificates. Don't worry, we'll provide enough time I'll close the link by 1:25, still 10 minutes more. The feedback mail ID is different from login ID. No issue, sir. That's okay. But kindly check your all the mails which you have provided. We'll try to verify that and rectify the mail ID. But kindly check the mails for the certificates which you have provided already. Thank you. Thank you, Krishnak sir. Thank you. Really, it was amazing compliment. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello. This is Dr. Abdurrahman from Saudi Arabia.
Yes, sir.
It was a very nice presentation so far. I attended almost all the sessions. Very impressive and initiatives. Very good. Thank you for your support and effective organized session of all the teamwork. Thank you for all.
No, sir. Thank you so much for your compliments.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Mr. Pramod Gowda, sir, feedback will not be shared to mail IDs. I have posted in the chat box. Kindly click that link and provide the feedback now itself, sir. Certificates will be mailed shortly, sir, within few days. We have to undergo some verifications all the 5 days of feedback. Once it is done, we will shortly send the certificate, sir. It will not take much time. Kindly wait for 1 or 2 days. We'll surely send it. We are not sure about the presentations, but we'll share the recording sessions. All the 5 days, which is 10 sessions, recording session is available. We'll share all the recordings along with your certificates. So don't worry.
Mr. Narendra Kumar, sir. Your video is turned on. Kindly check. It's in a recording mode. Kindly check.
Still, around 48 participants are available here. Have you filled the feedback form? Still, if you are not filled, kindly fill it soon. Sure, sir. I have been Srinivasan, sir. We'll surely share all the recordings will be imported in a single drive link, and we will share the drive link. We will share it in the WhatsApp group too. Sure, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Those who have filled the feedback form can kindly leave the meeting. Thank you for your active participation. Thank all the faculties for participating in our 5 days FDP. Sure, Deepa ma'am, we will intimate you for further workshops or any other FDPs in future. All the faculties will be mailed with future events too. Those who have filled the feedback and kindly leave the meeting. Those are still facing some issues or those are not filled the feedback, kindly wait for some time and fill it soon, please. Those who have filled the feedback can leave the meeting so that we can make sure that there is no issue for you. Thank you for your active participation.